Hey guys, so today we're going to take this $20 cake and turn it into this spectacular Santa Claus cake. So let's get started. You guys see my son? Oh, look at my son putting on my glasses. Hey everyone, my name is Tim Allen. Welcome to Koalipops. I'm really excited about this cake. Mostly because I shot this video a month ago and I vaguely remember the footage, so I think it kind of looks cool. So it's gonna be fun to see the footage all over again. So I'm gonna take my cake out. I bought it at Food for Less because it's super cheap. I chose chocolate cake because chocolate sheet cake from grocery stores, it's like so moist. There's only one recipe that I've been able to find that is as moist as chocolate sheet cake. And that's the chocolate cake recipe on the back of the Hershey's cocoa box. Now I took the icing off the sides of my cake, and you can totally skip this because it's gonna come off when you start carving Santa's shape. But I did have to flatten out the top. Now this is just a rough draft because it changed so much when I started to create the cake. I don't know why I made his beard so pointy. I didn't like that, so I ended up changing that too. Now carving this cake sucked because the icing is so thick, it's so sticky, and it just kept getting stuck to my knife, so I had to clean it off several times. Yeah, it was really messy, but yo, the thickness of the icing made eating the cake scraps just that much better. I ate it with a warm glass of milk watching Love Actually. So bomb. Now to carve this cake, I didn't really do much. I just rounded out the sides a little bit. Usually with faces, I'd probably round the face out a little bit more, but because I have to account for the fullness in Santa Claus's beard, I didn't really do that. Then it was time to start building my Santa Claus face. So we got some skin tone fondant, and to create his beard, I actually rolled out the fondant a lot thicker just so that there'd be a difference in thickness around his face. So I worked the fondant around the cake, and then I just started to add a little bit of detail. I didn't want to add too much detail. I wanted his beard to look super clean, like it was in a Rogaine commercial or something. I felt like the less detail on the beard, the cleaner it would look, and I was right. Now his hat is a very thin piece of red fondant. I made it thin because I knew there would be a thicker piece going on. And that thicker piece is the rim of the hat. I added so much more texture to the rim of the hat so that I could differentiate it from his beard because it's the exact same color, and I wanted to make sure that it didn't get lost in all the white in his beard. Oh, it looks so thick and full. I love how fluffy everything looks. Now we got a Santa face going on. To be quite honest, this Santa came from three different Google search images. The eyes, the beard, and the hat from three different Santas. I put them all together and this is what I got. The eyes that I liked came from a Santa Claus that had a really thin beard. And it looked like Santa Claus, but like if Santa Claus was on keto and he like dropped 100 pounds and now he's like underweight, it's just very malnourished looking. You know, that kind of Santa Claus. I want Santa Claus to have like a full grand beard, and so that's what I gave him in this cake. I added some catch lights and boom, my Santa Claus cake was complete. Can you believe it? This was a store-bought cake. A $20 cake, and I turned it into this very cute masterpiece. It's so weird because you don't see the chocolate mess that I was in before. It just looks very clean. I hope this fat guy leaves me some presents this year. I'm gonna be mad. So I've got a ton of ideas when it comes to transforming store-bought cakes, but I'm curious, what would you like to see me do? I know I said I was gonna do Ahsoka and Wonder Woman, but I'm doing them with cakes that I'm baking because I wanna use my skull cake mold so that they got that really nice bone structure. Thank you for all the comments on my last video. What do you think, my haircut? I like it. It's so different, isn't it? What I really don't like about this haircut is that when I'm outside and I'm wearing a mask, usually I can feel the wind like brush against my curls. I don't get that same effect with this haircut. Now somebody asked about where I get my supplies. I used to go to a bake shop, but now because I don't want to leave my house, I buy everything, almost everything on Amazon. Especially the Barbies that I use because I can't go from store to store hunting for the right Barbie, and I can find them all in one place. And that's Amazon. Wow, this is such a commercial. Price points are different though, depending on what vendor you're sort of buying from. I try to go from the official ones, but if I really want the Barbie and they don't have it in stock, then I will go for like third party. Yeah, let me know if you have any more questions about things. I'm gonna try to answer them at the end of every video. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you're having a wonderful holiday. Be good, so the fat man will leave you presents too. I love you guys. I'll see you very soon. Peace.